This is the Faith Fight Podcast. Today we're talking about how to come back when you make a mistake. Hello everyone, thank you for tuning into this new episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I'm your host, Chris Creary, and I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. Thank you for taking the time out of your day to listen, and I'm praying that all is well with you and that this episode blesses you. For all of my first-time listeners, I want to let you know that the podcast is available on all of the major podcasts and apps out there, on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible. So if you use any of those apps to listen to any other podcast, you can search for the Faith Fight Podcast, and you'll be able to follow this podcast or subscribe on those apps and download and listen to any one of the past episodes that I've done and receive every future episode that I'll release of the podcast as well. I release new episodes every Monday morning so you can start your week off on the right foot with something encouraging, something spiritual, something to help you grow and start your week off with the right mindset so that you can be who God called you to be and take dominion on this earth, which is what He wants you to do. And something new that I've done is I've also put the podcast on YouTube. So if you listen to podcasts on YouTube, you can find the Faith Fight Podcast there as well. Again, all you need to do is just search the Faith Fight Podcast and you'll be able to find it on YouTube. And for those regular listeners back again listening to another episode today, thank you so much for listening. And I know that something you listened to in the past blessed you or encouraged you or helped you in some way, or you wouldn't be back again. And because it did help you before, I'm going to encourage you to share this episode with someone else. Today we're going to talk about how to come back when you make a mistake. In the previous episodes, in the past couple weeks, I talked about overcoming the flesh and quieting the flesh. And last week, I explained the Moses principle for defeating the flesh. And now we're talking about when you make a mistake and you fall, how to come back. So if you know anyone that would want to listen to either one of the past episodes that I released last couple weeks or this episode, share it with them so that they can listen, be blessed, and be encouraged. Because God wants us to be in close relationship with Him. He doesn't want anything to cause us to be separate from Him, and sin will separate us from God. And this is why He gave His Son Jesus, so that we will always be able to have a way to get back into relationship with Him. So I say all that to say, share this episode with someone else so that we can all be in relationship with God and not allow sin to keep us separate from Him. As long as we have breath in our lungs, there is a way that we can come back to God when we make a mistake. Sin separates us from God, but Jesus is the bridge that reconnects us back to Him. We should try to live a sinless life, but at times we will fall and we will fail. And when it happens, it's not a surprise to God. In fact, He already made a way for us to get back into relationship with Him. Today, we are going to go over some verses that we can remember when we sin and fall short of the glory, the mark that He has set for us. But at the same time, when He sets that mark for us, He gives us a way to come back into relationship with Him through Jesus Christ, our Savior. So let's get started today. The first verse for this episode is Psalms 145, verse 14. It says, "The Lord upholds all who fall and raises up all who are bowed down." So when we sin, the fastest way to get back into relationship with God is to humble ourselves and repent. We can come to God in prayer, bow our knees and confess our sins. And when we humble ourselves and confess our sins, He forgives us because of the sacrifice that Jesus has made for us to lift us back up into relationship and in right standing with Him. So remember to humble yourself when you fall, repent, and come back into relationship with Him. Next, I'm going to read Psalms 139, verse 8. It says, "If I ascend into heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there." So the reason why I include this verse is to let you know, regardless of where you are in your walk with God, even if you made some decisions that caused you to sin, God is still there with you. This verse says that even if I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there. So God has not left you. He has not forsaken you. And he is always there waiting for you to come back into relationship with him. There is nothing that you can do in this life that can cause you to be separate from him and for him not to extend forgiveness to you so that you can be back into relationship with him. He will always be there for you and waiting for you to come back unto him to repent for your sin, and he will forgive you and cause you to be in right relationship again through Jesus Christ our Savior. Next, I'll read Proverbs 24 verse 16. It says, "For a righteous man may fall 7 times and arise again, but the wicked shall fall by calamity." So there may be times when we are tripped up by the same sin over and over and over again. This is especially the case when you are a new believer, but also it may happen after years of walking with Christ. The key part of this verse that we all need to remember is that when you fall, don't stay down. Don't stay in that place of guilt and condemnation. Get up, repent, ask God to forgive you, and ask the Holy Spirit to help you so that you can overcome that temptation in the future. Next, I'll read Romans 8, verse 1. It says, "There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit." So without Jesus, we would have no hope at all in this world. There would be no way for us to pay the price for our sins for ourselves. But if you are a believer in Jesus, God says that you stand before him with no condemnation, no guilt, and no shame because of your sin. And I'm going to read Romans 8:28 next. It says, "And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to his purpose." So when we are saved, we have purpose and destiny. Even if we sin, God can still use it for his glory as part of our testimony. When you have overcome a specific sin and you no longer submit to it, God can then use you to help others who struggle with that same thing. This is one way that God can work it out for the good, because we love him and we are called for his purposes. And his purpose is so that all may come to know him, repent for their sins, and be in relationship with him. And he can work in our lives to reach other people. Next, I'll read James 1, verses 2 to 4. It says, "My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing." So when we repent and come back into relationship with God, we may still feel some guilt for our sin that we just committed. This is the devil trying to keep you away from God and to hinder your relationship with him. We can learn from these situations and mature in our Christianity on how to stay connected to God and how to overcome the temptations of the flesh. But it's a matter of reflecting on what you did wrong and the decisions that you made so that you can mature and not make those same decisions to choose the flesh again. And I'll read 1 John 1 verse 9 next. And it says, "If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." So confession frees us to enjoy a relationship with God. It will free our conscience and remove guilt. True confession involves a commitment not to continue in sin, but God is faithful to forgive and cleanse us. We should also pray for strength to defeat the temptation the next time that we face it. And finally, in this episode, I'll read Micah 6, verse 8. It says, "He has shown you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God." So this is what God wants from us. He wants our love and obedience. He is a personal God and expects a personal relationship with us. As we love God's mercy, because we need God's mercy every single day, we also are merciful to others around us. And this is what God expects from us, to reciprocate the mercy that He has shown to us, to other people in our lives. So now it's time to pray concerning this episode. So if you are doing anything that requires your attention, keep your eyes open. I'm going to pray and you can agree with me through saying amen. Heavenly Father, thank you for this awesome privilege that we get, oh God, to come into your presence in prayer. You are so wonderful, God of all the earth and of all creation, Lord God, the one who has no beginning and no end, the sovereign, wonderful God, we thank you as we come before your presence, Lord. We ask for mercies, Lord. Forgive us and cleanse us if we had done anything, O God, that was sinful in your sight. Purify our hearts and our minds as we enter before your presence right now in prayer. And we thank you, Father God, for the blood of Jesus that cleanses us, purifies us, O God, and helps us to walk uprightly before you, Lord God. Thank you for this privilege that we have to come to you in prayer, Lord. And we come, O God, thanking you for the mercies that you've shown, O God, when we make mistakes, Lord God. For your word says that it's you that upholds all who fall and raises up all who are bowed down low, Lord God. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you will help us all to remain humble, Lord God, before you, and that when we fall, when we miss the mark, Lord God, that we will humble ourselves and come back to you, Lord God, and acknowledge, oh God, that we have failed in a particular area, Lord God. And Lord, as we confess, Lord God, our sins, oh God, you are faithful to forgive us and cleanse us and lift us back up again, Lord God. And we thank you so much, Lord God, that there is no sin, oh God, that you cannot forgive, Lord God. And your word says that even if we make our bed in hell, there you are with us, Lord God. So I thank you that there is no decision that we have made, O God, that will cause you to turn your back upon us, Lord God. And your word also goes on to say that the righteous falls 7 times, O God, and rises again. So Father, I pray through the power of your Holy Spirit, Lord God, that if anyone listening right now, O God, has failed or sinned, Lord God, and if they are stuck in a spiral of guilt and condemnation, Father God, I pray that your Holy Spirit will encourage them, O God, to rise up right now and get back into relationship with you, O God. For all have sinned and fallen short of your glory, your word says, Lord God. But I thank you, Lord God, that it's because of Jesus and the sacrifice that he has made that we can come back into relationship with you, that we are forgiven because all of what he has done, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, and not because of what we have done, Lord. And we thank you, Lord God, that it's in him, O God, that we may have forgiveness and be cleansed from our sin, O God, and that there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, Lord God. So, Father God, may the guilt, O God, be removed. May the condemnation be removed, and may the shame be removed from every single person if they are in a place right now where they have sinned, O God. And I thank you, Father God, for restoring the relationship, O God, with your sons and your daughters, O God, through Jesus. I pray that your Holy Spirit, O God, will encourage every single heart, O God, to get up out of that place, O God, of condemnation and guilt, and back into relationship with you, Father God. That your word, O God, is so true, Lord God, where it says that if we confess our sins, that you are faithful to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness, Lord God. All unrighteousness, Lord God, and forgive us from all our sins, Lord God. So I thank you for every single person listening, Lord God, that there is nothing, O God, that you cannot forgive us for, Lord God. And I pray that the Holy Spirit will implant this deep into our hearts, O God, so that we all may know, O God, that you forgive all sins, Lord God. All we need to do is confess our sins to you, Lord God. And we give you the praise for this, Lord God, that you are causing us to be mature and causing us to grow, O God, even through the failures, O God, and the sins that we may have tripped us up last time, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, that you will work all those things for the good, Lord God. And we give you the praise and the glory that it is part of our testimony, O God. And when you, O God, you have forgiven us and cleansed us, O God, we will go back and share, O God, your good news, O oh God, and help others, oh God, overcome those very same struggles, Lord God. So we thank you for hearing our prayer today, Lord God. We love you, we appreciate you, and we thank you, Father God, for allowing us, oh God, to be in right standing with you through Jesus Christ, oh God, knowing that our sins are not held against us, Lord God, but you, oh God, forgive us and separate our sins as far as the east is from the west, Lord God. So we commit our hearts and our lives to you now, Lord God, and I pray your blessings and your peace upon every single person under the sound of my voice right now, Lord God, that your name will be exalted and your will done in all of our lives, Father. We thank you for this. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So that's it for another episode of the Faith Fight Podcast, and I hope that you were blessed by this. And if you were blessed, you can go over to Apple Podcasts and you can subscribe to the podcast there, and you can write your testimony of how this podcast blessed you and put a 5-star review in there. And what that will do is it will help the podcast be ranked higher to allow more people to find the Faith Fight Podcast and listen and be blessed, just like how you were blessed. And if you have an Android phone, you can subscribe and listen to the podcast through Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible. All you need to do is just search the Faith Fight Podcast. And again, as I mentioned at the beginning, the podcast is also available on YouTube. So just search the Faith Fight Podcast and you'll be able to follow, subscribe, and listen to all of the episodes that I release on a Monday morning when I release them. Also, if this blessed you, share it with someone else so it can be a blessing to them as well. And as I mentioned at the beginning, I did an episode a couple weeks ago on overcoming the flesh and also talking about the Moses principle, which is a very practical step-by-step guide for you to overcome temptations. And you can go back and listen to those episodes, and I've placed links for them in the description of this episode so that you can listen, be encouraged, and be blessed by those episodes. And that's all that I have to say for this episode. Remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you'll hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Something good is going to happen to you today. Be blessed, everyone.